gets the pass away. They get it up to center ice. Niewendyk is striding in there for Toronto, and they scores! Niewendyk put that through Lalime, and the Leafs are ahead 2-0. Oh, my. Lalime wants that one back. You don't get him back.
No, you don't, and he should have had that. It was a 45-foot wrist shot, and Lalime blew it. And often it's not that the goal went in, it's how it went in to deflate everyone. And how he missed this one, I don't know. He could have taken his glove hand off and caught it barehanded. He's had a terrific playoff, but he missed this one, and his team's in a hole now.
Jacques Martin, of course, has called a timeout. Let's regroup, fellas. It's 2-0, and this is game 7. We've just come off an electrifying overtime win against this team the other night. Let's start all over. Let's get these back if we can. 2-0, Toronto. Two goals in a minute and 22 seconds. And for Bob with 27 seconds left in this, the first period. That one was too high for DeVries. Here's Niewendyk again. Scores again. Right through Lalime. Two in a row for Niewendyk. What's going on? This time, same angle though.
Well, I thought that the play might have been offside on the pass coming up right here. Pretty close, his feet were probably on the line, but you can't score in practice from that angle on any kind of a goaltender. And Patrick Lalime, with these last two Niewendyk goals, has put his team in a huge crevice.
First period in game 7. Who would